ももし生まれ変わったらその時はさ。
Hello loves, welcome back to another video. Today we are reading Our Destiny, a Himiko Toga ex-listener, written by my bestie Alana, so please give her kudos in the comments. So originally there are three more chapters left, but I'm going to be finishing chapters 4, 5, 6, and 7. Sorry, I don't know why I said 3, there's 4, right? Because they are short, and we're just gonna finish it all in this part, so I hope you enjoy. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Chapter 4, Shoto's POV. I am the hostage. Where am I? I said, lifting my head up to see where I was. I look around, and it looks like I'm in a bar. I look to see a tall man sleeping on the couch. I try to move, but I'm tied up and chained. I try to use my quirk. I can't use my quirk, I say, whispering. I move more, making noise. Oh, you're finally awake. I hear a voice. I look up to see a tall man standing up off the couch and walking towards me. I freeze in fear. I can't move. What's happened to me? Are the heroes coming to save me? Will they make it in time before he kills me? What does he want? Does he want money or information about the school? Wait, he's coming closer. I don't want to die yet. A million thoughts are going through my head. I could see him reach his arm out. I close my eyes, shut in fear, and I put my head down. He puts his hand on my shoulder. Hey, are you okay? I'm not gonna hurt you. I look back at the man. There's something familiar about him. I think to myself, here, I'm gonna untie you, but I'm gonna tie you to the floor, okay? The man says. I just nod my head. He unties me and ties me to the metal piece on the floor. I can move more freely now. What's your name? I ask him. Oh, you can call me Dabby. Dabby says, okay, Dabby, what do you want from me? I look at him. Who, me? I want nothing of yours. You are just here so the heroes can come and save you. Dabby says, sitting at the bar. I was shocked. I thought he wanted something, but clearly not. I saw him go up and walk into another room. He dragged out a small mattress and laid it right next to me. What are you doing? I ask him. Oh, nothing, just giving you a place to sleep, Dabby says, going back into the room, and comes out with a pillow and some blankets. Here, lay down and go to sleep. I'm tired, so I'm gonna go to sleep. No doubt the heroes will come tonight, Dabby says, fixing the bed, then walks to the couch and lays down with blankets over his head. I get up off the chair and lay down on the bed and get comfortable. Well, at least I don't have to sleep in the chair. I think to myself, well, thank you. Good night, I guess. I say falling asleep. Good night, kid. Dabby says falling asleep also. In the morning, I wake up to a smell of food and people talking. I move around, sitting up, moving my hair out of my face. Aw, look who's finally awake. A person with long white hair that's almost touching the ground walks up to me. I move back a little, not knowing who they are. Aw, come on, Tundra, they're scaring him. Come back, a girl says. Okay, coming, Tundra says back. What would you like to eat? Says a mist purple person. Is it okay if I can have some cold soba? I say nervously. Sure thing, kid, the purple mist says. Thank you, sir, I say. After a few minutes, the purple mist comes up to me and bends down, giving me some food. Here you are, I hope you enjoy, he says. I take the food and start eating. Wow, this is really good. It's better than how I make it, I think to myself, still eating. When I'm eating, I listen to the conversation of the villains. They're laughing and having fun. They actually look like they're a family. I smile. I don't know why, but I do. After I'm done eating, I stand up with the bowl in my hands and walk as far as the train will let me go. Sir, here's my bowl, and I want to thank you. It was delicious. It was better than how I make it. Is it okay if you teach me? I say, still nervous. Thanks, Todoroki. And yeah, I wouldn't mind teaching you if Master says it's okay. He says and looks at the leader. Yeah, sure, whatever. Dabby, make the chain longer, the leader says. After Dabby made my chain longer, I was able to move around more. As the purple mist was teaching me, I learned his name was Kogoroi. He added different ingredients, which made the soba taste better, and he gave me the recipe. I was so excited to show my brother Natsuo. I was having a good time with them until the leader got a call. He hung up and all he said was, "They're coming," and everyone scattered like cockroaches. Dabi picked me up and put me back on the bed and tightened my chain, and I knew the heroes were coming. I say, as he just nodded, I didn't want to leave, but I knew that they were villains and I had to go back to the heroes. They looked like they were ready to fight. Then I heard a crash and the rest is all a blur. I see different quirks being used and all I hear are some people yelling, "They got away!" Then the next thing I knew, I woke up in a hospital. Chapter 5, Your POV, Mission Complete. We were ready to fight. The heroes got Shoto, the League tried to escape, but Race Ahead had erased Kokogori's quirk. But luckily, all of one had a similar quirk and teleported us to Kamino, where the Nomu factory is. But when we got there, there were pro heroes destroying the factory. "Crap, I totally forgot about Mama," you said to yourself. "What do we do? I mean, let's fight them," Twice said. "Let's hide until Master gets here," Shigaraki says, and we hide. When all of one shows up, we come out. "The plan is in motion," he says, and we all nod, and went to get some of the Nomus and scatter them all over the city to keep some of the pose heroes busy, and we meant to stay out of the way. All of one was to fight All Might. We did exactly that. Luckily, we had a second base already for Kokori, opened a portal, and we went through it. By the time Dabi set up the TV to watch the news, we saw All for One standing on top of what seemed to be All Might's dead body, and it was, "Master won the fight," I heard Shigaraki scream. Then everyone was so happy. Some started to cry out of pure joy. Some ran in circles, aka twice in spinner. Toga and Yu started to scream up and down in happiness. You're glad that the plan had worked. You picked up Toga with her legs wrapping around your waist and spun her around. You looked at her face so happy. You looked at her golden yellow eyes that were so bright, and you went to lay down but couldn't. She grabbed you from the side of the head and kissed you passionately. You were surprised by this, but you actually kissed her back equally as passionate. She let go to catch her breath. I'm sorry, I just really wanted to kiss you," Toga says, turning her head. You can see that her face is bright red. "So cute," you think to yourself. "It's okay, I really liked it," you say. "Why don't just tell her how much you love her already? I'm tired of this soppy crap," Dabi says. Toga turns her head to you and looks at you. You look to the floor embarrassed. "No, you're blushing. How cute. You love me, huh?" Toga says, and you nod your head slowly. "Come on, tell me," Toga says. She wants me to tell her. "Does she let you back?" You think to yourself. You look at Toga, straight in her eyes, and with all the confidence you say, "I love you, Himiko, Toga. Will you be my girlfriend?" You look at her face, and her face was getting redder. "Yes, yes, I would love to be a girlfriend," Toga says, kissing you again. You finally let her down and you hugged her tightly. After the League had settled down, All for One had come back. So what do we do now? We had failed our objective, you asked him. Well, if this plan didn't work, and it did, I'm letting you go. You can go do whatever you want. If you want, you can still be a villain. It's your choice. I'm going back to my wife and kids. You don't have to take orders from me anymore, All for One said, and turned and walked away. Everyone was shocked. We didn't know what to do. We were villains. You had no idea. "Hey guys, I know what to do. How about we go back to our families as well? Dabi, go back to your little brother. And for the people who don't have families, we should just live together somewhere far, far away where no one knows us and live a normal life. We want to let's live. Let me call Kaminari to tell him the news," you said, and everyone was satisfied with that answer. "Hey Kaminari," you say. "Yeah, why are you not up?" Kaminari says back. "You're free. We're all free. You don't have to be a villain anymore. Do whatever you want. You can stay at UA if you want. Become a hero if you want. Change the world. Tell Shinzo good luck on whatever you choose," you say. "Yeah, I will. And thank you for telling me. Goodbye to you too, Wayan," Kaminari says back. "Bye, Kaminari," you say, and hang up. Shoto's POV, Chapter 6, The Reunion. It's been 6 months that anyone has seen the League of Villains. People say they split up, some people say they died, some people say they're planning something again. I don't know. I just hope that they're okay, at least. And even though they killed All Might, I feel bad for them. I don't know why, so don't ask me. The doorbell rang. I gets up and open to see the door. The villain, Darby, but his hair is white. I look at him more closely and I see it. It's him. It's Toya. I start to cry.
He said hi.
I say in a low voice, "Hey, Shoto. I'm sorry that I left. I'm sorry for everything I did wrong to you. Hope you can forgive me," Darby says in a hopeful voice. I hug him tightly. He seems surprised because it took a second for him to hug me back. He was crying. "Come on in, we have to tell Natsu and Fuyumi. They would be delighted to see you," I say, letting him go and dragging him inside. "Just so you know, Father is here," I say nervously. "It's okay, I want to talk to him too," Darby says, looking around the house. Chapter 7, Your POV, the beginning of a new chapter. It's been 6 years, and you and some of the League had moved it somewhere when nobody knew who you were, or the League were. You and Toga finished high school and went to college. You became a teacher, and Toga became an artist. Shigaraki became a coffee shop owner for villains. Twice Kogori, Spinner, and Mr. Compress work there. It is quite popular. "I'm happy for them," you say to yourself. You talk to Darby to see how he was doing. He was doing great. Darby forgave his father and now have a better relationship with him. He's not doing anything special. He's just trying to keep his head down. But he told you that he was training to be a hero with Shoto and he's happy to be with his family again. You and Toga are happily married. "Why, and hurry up! Come on, the movie is starting!" Toga yells from the couch to you upstairs. "Coming!" You yell, running down the stairs and jump off the couch to sit right next to Toga. Okay, loves, I hope you enjoyed that. Honestly, I don't know where the British accent came from. Honestly, I don't know what possessed me to do that, but I guess, yeah. Honestly, British accent is so much easier to do than American accent. Like, American accent, you have to actually try and stuff, and in British accent, you don't really have to try to do anything. You can just talk, you know? Okay. Yep, okay, that's it. I'm gonna go edit this. Bye, loves. Oh, and before I go, one thing. I'm sorry for not posting yesterday. We actually left LA yesterday around, 8 or 9. And I did have some time to do this video, but I was under the impression that we were leaving today, I believe. So, that's why I did. Okay, I don't have an excuse, I'm sorry. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye, loves.